go.
But first, to the film we've all heard about, and a few people have already seen it sneak previews in the past week, The Blair Witch Project.
It's Mr. Punctuality! How the hell are you this morning?
So I got the CP up.
Good. That's important, because that's what we're shooting on.
No one knows I took it, but I got it.
All right, come on, into the house. Come on, come on. I can see you. We're not going to bump into shit. I'm running backwards now. Okay, we don't want to f*** up the cameras before we leave. Hey, nice camera, man.
An opening title explains that in October 1994, three student filmmakers hiked into the Black Hills Forest in Maryland to make a 16mm documentary about a legendary witch, and that they never returned. A year later, the material they shot was discovered, and it's been pieced together. And that's what we're about to see. With assertive Heather Donahue, calling the shots, the two young men, cameraman Joshua Leonard, and soundman Michael Williams, tag along. At first, all goes well as they shoot colour video material and black and white film of interviews with locals. And then they plunge into the dense woods, where they quickly get lost and realise that someone or something is menacing them in the dark.
I am so... so sorry for everything that has happened. Because in spite of what Mike says now, it is my fault. Because it was my project. And I insisted. I insisted on everything.
Well, the Blair Witch Project purports to be assembled from authentic film and video footage shot by the missing students, but of course it isn't. What we're seeing is pure fiction, though the actors who play the students actually did film the material themselves, which gives a rare authenticity to the creepy material. What's amazing is that this terribly low-budget, almost amateurish film, which was written, edited and directed by Daniel Myrick and Eduardo Sanchez, has been so phenomenally successful, raking in hundreds of millions of dollars. For once, the nausea-inducing handheld camera work is justified, though it's still hard to watch at times. But the film's greatest asset is its impressive soundtrack, which really adds to the mounting unease and terror. It's an incredibly simple film, yet on its own modest level, a very successful one. Margaret.
David, just looking at those clips again makes me all creepy. I found this the scariest experience ever, I think, in a film.
Why?
I don't know, because they've got this concept that they go for. They don't compromise on it, which I think is really terrific.
Yeah.
I think the performances of the three actors are so realistic and convincing, without which the film wouldn't work at all. I just found it really invigorating, fresh and really terrifying.
So we're sort of seduced into thinking that it really is happening.
David, I'm seduced into thinking everything really happens on the screen. I mean, that believability factor is so important to me about whether a film works or not. And this worked splendidly.
This is a sort of cinema verite horror film, isn't
yes.
it?
Yes. Yeah. I love being scared witless in this film. And I loved it.
I was too, I must say. I mean, not so much scared, but I found it very, very creepy.
Yeah, well, I think it's an amazing achievement of the two filmmakers. Really amazing. I'm giving it 4.5 stars.
I'm giving it 3.5.
I insisted that we weren't lost. I insisted that we keep going. I insisted that we walk south. Everything had to be my way. And this is where we've ended up. And it's all because of me that we're here now. Hungry. And cold. And hunted. I love you, Mom. And Dad. I am so sorry.
The Blair Witch Project opens nationally tonight, possibly at a cinema near you.